There's that fucked up sense of humor. He's like, I'll drink that shit. It'll jack you up. Nah, man, but I love life. It's the little things, really. It's the small, tiny things. Like, oh, I'll tell you one more thing I love. I love laying in bed late at night, right next to my beautiful, smoking wife. And I'm laying there in bed. She's asleep like a little princess, and I'm watching these things called Forensic Files. Like, Investigative Discovery Channel. Like, what the fuck is that shit? It's brilliant. I'm addicted. The show's called Disappeared, you know, these Forensic Files. And this brand new one that I love is called Who the Fuck Did I Marry? Judy married Jim 10 years ago. She put $10,000 down on his life insurance and killed him with liquid Drano. For 10 grand? I mean, I'm like, but the liquid Drano, I was like, good job. Like, out of a turkey baster. Like, seriously, she leaves it in the garbage can. You know, so, I'm sorry. I love that. But anyway, I'm sitting there watching these shows. It's like 2 a.m. and I'm so into these shows. I remember the other night, I'm laying there watching these shows and I'm not feeling right, you know? I kind of shake my wife, baby, wake up. Wake up, baby, wake up. Wake up. And she's like, what, honey, what? And I go, mate, baby, Remember when you said you'd always be there for me? Remember when you said you love me and you talked to me when I need to talk? She's like, okay, baby, what's wrong? And I go, I love you. And I know you love me too. But let's just say down the road, if you meet like a Brad Pitt looking motherfucker, right? He's really hot and you want to leave me and... Can we, like, just talk about it over some coffee and, you know, shake the hand? It was a good run, you know? Can you not slowly poison me when I sleep? She looks at me and she goes, sure. She goes to sleep, nah. But those are the things I love in life, is those things. Looking in my children's eyes. Now I can... It doesn't matter if they don't show up when I go see my daughter now. Now I don't beat my fucking head against the wall. I sit in a quiet spot in that airport, and I pray for them. And I say, Mary, God, just please watch over them. You're never going to change people. You can always pray for them, though. So now I just go on with my life, and I move forward. And I don't look back. And if you got drama, say the fuck over there. Because you know? I created all that shit for way too long. But also when I got out, I had to write you guys a new album, remember? That shit was crazy. So what do you mean? I can't go roll a joint now and have a glass of cover, right? No. Because once you have that sip, you're off to the races, dog. And you play the tape out. That's what I always say, play the tape out. How's it gonna end up? It's not about me anymore. So I had to write this album. So I fly back to Nashville, and I meet with this guy named Chris Lindsay, right? Because Nashville's a spiritual place for me now. And I walk into this guy's place, and I'm like, hey, I got like 3 months sobriety under my belt. He's like, so we're here to write together. And I'm like, yeah. He goes, what do you want to write about? And I tell him my story, and I was like, well, the only thing I really know right now is the respect and love I have for my wife. And he goes, well then why don't we write a song about your wife? And I go, that would be great. That would be awesome, man. Thank you. And then we start writing it and I have this fucking panic attack. Just, oh my God. I remember getting so uncomfortable. I said, excuse me, sir, I gotta just go outside real quick. And this is like I'm a professional writer, you know, so I'm embarrassed as hell. So I walk outside and I grab a Marlboro Light and a black cup of black coffee. Hey, it's me again. Need some help. Just show me that I can do it still. Because I don't know if I can. And I can honestly tell you that I'm scared. So please just let me go back in there and honor my wife with a song about her. It has nothing to do with me. Just honor her. So I walked right back into that place, and I swear to God, 30 minutes later, this was real. I know how to let you leave. How am I supposed to let you go? Now you stand in front of me, and all the rain's turning into snow. So can you tell me that you're real, so I can really know that everything standing next to me, homeless person I can be, is finally here and he won't back down at all. But I can't stop thinking how you just keep making sense of all that was broken before. And I won't keep faking, cause I'm done with taking with you. I'm not broken anymore. And I've seen the empty deep. I dammed up that water flow. Baby, you're the touchstone. You're my complete. You're the ship that kept me afloat. So can you tell me that you're real, so I can really know that everything I feel I can finally show? Cause when you're standing next to me, homeless person I can be is finally here and he won't back down at all. But I can't stop thinking how you just keep making sense of all that was broken before. And I won't keep faking, cause I'm done with taking with you. I'm not broken anymore. But I can't stop thinking how you just sense of all.